My Hero Academia is a great show. It has sincerity, it has heart, it has kinetic energy, amazing characterization, and boundless creativity. And beyond that, it's just really, really, really funny. What's not to love about this show? Well, normally, that's a rhetorical question, but let me tell you that this show has one deep, powerfully fatal flaw, and his name is Mineta, the great themed pervert that's a stain on an otherwise shining show. Look, I'm no anime expert, but I'm also not a stranger to anime. I get that fan service isn't a new thing, and I get that it's not surprising. I'm there to appreciate shows like Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood, which keeps things pretty tasteful and manages to avoid turning all of its women into weird, sexy babies. But I also know how to look back on Gurren Lagann or One Piece and appreciate the amazing things about it, despite the unfortunate abundance of, you know, abundance. Yes, in a lot of situations, anime is near synonymous with a weird, over-the-top cheesecake horniness. It's like a waterlogged body dredged from the river, where the river is made of uncomfortable horniness. But I can't help but feel that Mineta is a very particular problem, a sore thumb that sticks out on a show that's otherwise extremely clever, mature, and subversive. Why is this guy even here? His whole deal is that he's extremely small, freaks out constantly, has basically a useless quirk that makes him no fun to watch in fights. His only utility is being extremely horny, hornier than anyone was ever meant to be, like if Spanish Fly snorted a line of Viagra and then was also a horny man baby with grape shit for a head. And that's the nice way of putting it. To put it more fairly, he's the type who'd do anything to invade a woman's privacy against her wishes. Female characters are just sex objects to him. It's gross. It's embarrassing. And I mean, actually embarrassing. Because My Hero Academia is a damn near perfect show to introduce people to anime. Easily pitched as Marvel meets Harry Potter, it's super easy to get people excited about it. It sucks to have to issue one big caveat. Oh yeah, sorry, by the way, the show prominently features the purest distilled example of the thing that gives anime a bad reputation to begin with. It's shocking what a tone-deaf character choice this is. If you're someone, usually a woman, let's imagine, who has to deal with creepy dudes groping you, perving on you, harassing you, etc., seeing that kind of behavior treated as a source of humor might be a tough pill to swallow. The real bummer is, the show knows that it's better than this. My Hero Academia has managed to make intelligent, pointed commentary about the hypersexualization of anime women with the character 18 plus only hero Midnight. What a great name, also. But a character like this, who's used in a smart, savvy, and subversive way, still rings hollow because of Mineta. Beyond being a gross character, Mineta doesn't have any place amongst the rest of the cast. My Hero Academia is filled with characters who are supportive of each other. All the classmates at UA, Bakugo excluded, are there to encourage and help one another. They're all striving to be the best, but never at the expense of their friends. There's a genuine sense of camaraderie and empathy for one another, and that's really refreshing, which makes sense for a class of people who all aim to be, you know, heroes. Even the clip show that opened the most recent season was nice. Just little bits of original material that was mostly just Midoriya and friends all talking about how much they mean to one another and how they can never have gotten this far without being able to rely on their fellow heroes in training. But then there's Mineta, who's too busy being a lousy perv to meaningfully participate in all of this good-natured fun business happening over here in this extremely excellent part of the show. He's not just an incorrigibly hormonal teen, he's a sex predator and it bums me out. He's bringing nothing to the table and really just makes every scene worse. He drags down not only the plot, but the other characters as well. Instead of getting to see Midoriya and Tsuyu be badasses together, we have to listen to Mineta scream and cry. Momo was dragged down to like 17th place in the obstacle course just so we could get some shitty pervert gag from him, and we missed the chance to get some development for Zero just to have to listen to Mineta spew some bullshit about wanting to be cool. You'll never be cool, dude! Besides that, he acts like a dick to everyone in the class, and it makes it hard to believe that such a tight-knit class would tolerate an arrogant, rude pervert who's constantly sexually harassing the girls. Especially since most of the students are altruistic individuals aiming to be heroes. It also sucks because he's taking a spot in class 1A that could easily go to Shinso, a much more compelling character. Across a couple dozen episodes of this show, they've done an amazing job of characterizing and fleshing out even minor characters. Seriously, Midoriya's mom has become one of the most interesting three-dimensional characters on the show, and she's probably had somewhere around like 8 minutes of actual screen time total? Meanwhile, has Midetta had any big moments of redemption or selflessness? Or has he just been a wimpy, screaming loser creeper 100% of the time? You can't tell me that his screen time wouldn't be better spent on literally any other underserved character. Let's spend some more time with Dobby or check in with Mezo Shoji and his weird gross body. Give me extra scenes with Toru Hagakuri, anybody but Mineta. And what, would anyone actually miss Mineta? I'm not talking about his classmates now, I'm talking about, you know, viewers. No one likes this guy, he's nobody's favorite character. He's not your favorite character, is he? No judgment if he is, but... ugh. Look, anime has had a long history of creepy deepy bullshit, and at this point, Mineta's not just an anchor around the leg of the show, but also anime as a whole. And for what? Some backwards thinking sight gags that no one thinks are funny? Just have Tsuyu keep slapping them away until there's nothing left. Just a little pile of grape mush. That has more utility in the show. Just, slop. Grape slop. Better character right there. His name's Grape Slop. His quirk is that he doesn't suck as much as Mineta, and it's super useful.